Is one big story that is kicking it off for us because police, they are on high alert now for the Melbourne Cup, hoping that protesters don't derail this big day of celebrations. Tens of thousands converging on Flemington for this annual tradition. Today, Melbourne reporter Christina Hearn is there on course for us this morning. Chris, a lot of people heading there for a day of celebration, but police, what measures have they got in place to make sure things go smoothly?
Well, Tom, plenty of police will be deployed to keep a close eye on anti-racing protesters who are vowing to disrupt the event. $100,000 has actually been spent on security for the busy Flemington train line. I mean, at its peak, trains are departing here to the track every 4 minutes. So this year, drones and actually a mobile CCTV station will be used to make sure that line is clear. It has been targeted in the past by protesters, so organisers want to make sure that racegoers have a smooth ride here to the Flemington racetrack. Police will also be used at level crossings.
We know from previous years that there are certain vulnerabilities around the venue. We have careful tasking in place to ensure we've got the right degree of police and other support staff to ensure we can get trains in and out of the site.
As of late yesterday, we had a new Melbourne Cup favourite in the Chris Waller-trained Finch. Our second favourite is the Japanese stayer Murder Glass, followed by Constantinople from the Hayes stable. But out to win his first ever Melbourne Cup is jockey Craig Williams. He's pretty much won everything else in Australian racing, but the Cup has eluded him and he will be on board the Australian born, bred and owned Vow and Declare. Tom.
And we'll know the winner in about 8 hours' time. Christina Hearn out there nice and early. Thank you.